Hi guys, it's Anthony from Grandstand, and today we're talking tendons. We're going to be talking about how a tendon works normally, what happens when a tendon starts to break down, and most importantly, how to fix a tendon which is starting to break down. So for today's talk, we're going to be using this piece of rope to demonstrate our tendon. Now, our tendon is just like this piece of rope in that it's made up of lots of little fibres which are really well organised and compacted to give us a whole lot of strength in a tensile direction. Now, like this piece of rope, a tendon does not deal terribly well with rotation loads, nor does it deal well with loads where it's being bent, particularly over a bone or surface like that. So our normal tendon should look like this, very, very well organised. This next section of the model represents a tendon after we've loaded it, like going for a run or after a game of football, and we can see that there has been some damage occur to the tendon. Now this is a good thing because this damage is actually the stimulus for the body to make the tendon stronger and therefore able to deal with more loads later in the future. The most important thing is that we need to give our body the right environment to repair this damage. And the right environment is adequate rest and good nutrition to make sure that the damage following a load settles down quickly and we repair back to a normal, stronger tendon. If our load is too high or our rest period is too short, the body struggles to deal with the damage that we saw in the previous model. As a result, it increases the fluid within the fibres to try to make the tendon stiffer. Now, you can see in this tendon here, which is your typical swollen tendon, we've got fluid gathering through there and the fibres are starting to become a little bit more disorganised. If we continue to further push the tendon without giving it adequate rest, then we start to see neovascularization. And neovascularization is just a really fancy word to say blood vessels and nerves infiltrating into the tendon matrix. Now this is a problem because the blood vessels and the nerves are sensitive, and when they're compressed under load, they produce pain. And some of the tendon pain you're getting is from the direct pressure of these tissues in there. If you've had tendon pain for a while, you may have had an MRI or an ultrasound which demonstrated a tear of the tendon. And a tear is exactly what it sounds like, where you have a breakdown of some of the fibres of the tendon. Now importantly, this tendon's never going to repair itself and the tear will always be obvious on MRI or ultrasound, but that's not to say it's going to stop you getting back to activity. So, let's review those stages of the tendon one more time, this time focusing on what we do to try to make the tendon better. Remember, in our normal fatigue load, giving the tendon adequate rest and nutrition is enough to allow the tendon not only to recover, but also to improve to be a stronger tendon for next time you exercise. Once we've developed some swelling in the tendon, it's really a sign that your tendon is struggling to deal with the loads that you're placing on it. Now, this time, this might be an appropriate time for relative rest from the aggravating exercise. So if your tendon gets inflamed after running, giving yourself a short break from running may be the best thing for it. Now, importantly, don't stop exercising altogether. In fact, loading the tendon up in isometric exercises will help to push the fluid out of the tendon and return the tendon back to its normal matrix. If you're one of these people with this chronic degenerative tendon, you've got quite a lot of work to do to restore the tendon back to normal. Okay. This tendon will not respond well with rest, and in fact, rest will just make the tendon weaker without changing the nerves and the blood vessel, which means it's even more unlikely for you to be able to return to your exercise. Instead, what's paramount is to start to load this tendon, and the loading does two things. By isometrically loading the tendon, you can desensitize the nerves and the blood vessels to the compression, whilst also making the tendon stronger and more able to deal with load. For those of you who've had a tear diagnosed on an MRI or an ultrasound, keep in mind that that tear is always going to be visible under investigation. That's not to say you can't return to your exercise, but it does mean you need to load the tendon appropriately to make the remaining fibres strong enough to deal with the normal load. The aim of any good tendon rehabilitation program is to restore your tendon, whether it best be overworked, swollen and inflamed, degenerative or torn, back to a normal tendon. And this is absolutely achievable with the right loading parameters applied to it and avoiding rest. The other thing to keep in mind is that within any one tendon, you may have any number of different stages going on at different portions of the tendon. And that means it's absolutely critical to find the right load applied at the right time with right recovery to enable you to have a full recovery. I hope this model has given you a little bit more of an understanding of what's happening within your tendon, but also the importance of loading the tendon. Now, if you've got any questions about what's the right type of load for your tendon, please give us a call at Grandstand.